Hello and welcome to Swahili Kingdom. So today we are going to learn ways to say congratulations in Swahili. 18 plus phrases and even the slang phrases will be included just a little so that when you hear someone saying it in the slang, you will not be confused. So in this life, we congratulate others or ourselves when we have achieved something. Would you like to know how to congratulate in Swahili? This video is for you in that case. For example, we have Hongera, which most of the people know that it means congratulations. Learn how to congratulate others or yourself in Swahili using this video in more than 18 ways. So we have 18 phrases. Some colloquial will also be included for you to be at the same pace with someone who uses it. So don't feel like you are out of the context when someone is talking in the slang and you only know the Swahili sanifu one. It's good to know Kiswahili sanifu, but it's also good to know some other phrases from here and there. It will improve your skills. Hello, do you want to cram vocabularies with no struggle? Use this app. It has all the 5 levels, the beginner, the intermediate, up to the expert. So go download this app in the description link below and support Swahili Kingdom. It even has a chat mate. You can chat with a bot right here, and we have daily native conversations. We have notes. Get direct translations from here, and it has 60 plus languages. So stop waiting and get this. Thanks a lot for listening to that. Go get the app. The link is in the description box below and use it to improve every day. So the first one you have, Hongera. Congratulations. Example, Hongera, umepita mtihani. Congratulations, you've passed the exams. Another one, pongezi. It's like sensational, sensational, but it also means congratulations. Pongezi kwa kupata kazi. Congrats for getting a job. Pongezi kwa kupata kazi. Number 3, Kongole. Respect, regards, but it is also insinuating congrats, congratulations. So example, umekuwa mtu mwenye bidii sana na ulistahili kupandishwa cheo. Kongole zangu nazikufikie. Then the fourth one, we have kazi nzuri. Nice work. This is when you do, like, this is maybe in school when a teacher congratulates you, just like that. Number 5, heshima zangu, my respects. This is not that much used, but it is a very nice way to congratulate someone. When someone has done something impeccable, you can just tell them heshima zangu. Okay, it means my respects, but you are also congratulating them. Example, umefaulu kupata kazi msimu huu, heshima zangu. You've managed to get work in this season, my respects, bro. So maybe that season it was hard for people to have jobs, but the person was able to find the job. Number 6, nakuvulia kofia, hats off for you. Number 7, wewe ni kiboko chao. This is one of a phrasal verb. See the video there at the right top corner, the phrasal verb in it. Number 9, endelea vivyo hivyo. Keep it up. This is what most of the people use. Maybe this is very official. This is very official. Maybe in the school or at work where someone will see that you have done something good and they will tell you, endelea vivyo hivyo. Keep it up. Number 10, endelea na kazi nzuri. This is also official. Keep up the good work. When someone sees that you have done something good, it is almost the same as number 9. Number 11, hiyo ndio njia, or huo ndio mwendo mzuri. Or you can say, huo ndio mwenendo mzuri. Way to go. Simple as that. So, hiyo ndio njia, huo ndio mwendo mzuri, or huo ndio mwenendo mzuri. Number 12, this is a slang. It is used most of the time, a slang. Number 12, hiyo ni kali or hiyo ni moto. And then number 13 is also slang. We ni mkali or we ni moto. We is short, is a short form of wewe. So you are amazingly great, unstoppable. This is a slang that is used. When someone tells you we ni mkali, they are like saying you are amazing, like congratulating you after you have done something that no one else has ever done, or you have done it amazingly. Number 14, moto wa kuotea mbali. This is also slang, okay? This is also slang, which means a fire to warm up yourself when you are far. So it's like you are fascinating, you are amazing. Example, wa, yeye ni moto wa kuotea mbali. Oh, she's fascinating. She has done something impeccable. Number 15, umeweza if it's someone, or imeweza if it's something. So this one you go with the prefixes that are supposed to be used. Like you can say kimeweza, okay? Using the prefixes like you are, that you need to use. Meaning you did it, or if it's a thing, it's stunning. Number 16, kazi njema or kazi poa. Most of the time you will hear people saying, especially here in Kenya, you will hear people saying kazi poa instead of kazi njema. But some other people speaking Swahili sanifu will say kazi njema, nice work. Number 17, vizuri sana, well done. Well done, this is official. This is official, where you can tell, maybe you can tell your colleague if they have done something good, something that they have never done before, you can tell them, vizuri sana. Endelea vivyo hivyo. Very good or well done. Continue like that. Number 18, pongezi, kongole, hongera, kwako. So we have added the word kwako to you. So this one means good for you or congrats to you. Okay? Number 19, mwendo or mwenendo mzuri. Nice going. When someone tells you mwenendo mzuri, just know that you are doing something nice and you should keep at that line. Number 20, you can pat someone on the shoulder. Guza mgongo. You can pat someone on the shoulder as a gesture. Okay, so let's see this conversation between two friends. Juma, habari yako Bakari? Bakari, nzuri sana, sijui yako. Ukoje lakini? When you want to know how to use the word aje, like I have suffixed it here, see the video there on the top. Juma, niko sawa. Bakari, nimepata fununu kuwa umetoboa kufuzu masomoni. Hukuwa hivyo zamani. Hongera kaka. Na kuvulia kofia. Akamguza mgongo. So akamguza mgongo, then pats his shoulder after congratulating him, saying hongera, and then putting letting off the hat, and then touches the shoulder. Then Juma akitabasamu, smiling, shukran tele. How to use the tele and so much more. Quantifiers, see the video above. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you have learned something great that you can use in your day-to-day life, or something that you can use in your long-term life. I don't know, something that you'll be able to use. If you have not subscribed yet, please click the subscription button so that you will be notified every time we post a video. And until next time, bye!